In this video, we are going to discuss an important topic, that is the sciatic nerve. So this is the nerve which lies in the posterior compartment of the thigh. We have discussed about the posterior compartment of the thigh in the previous video. Now we are going to discuss about the sciatic nerve. Now the sciatic nerve is a branch of which axis of nerves, that is it is a branch of sacral plexus, and it is the largest branch of sacral plexus. And one thing which is very particular about the sciatic nerve is that it is the thickest nerve in the body. It is the thickest nerve in the body, and it is the largest branch of sacral plexus. Now first we will discuss about the formation of the sciatic nerve. Now sciatic nerve is formed from anterior primary lamina of L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3 spinal nerves. So what you see here is the anterior primary lamina of L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3 spinal nerves. So just like we have discussed about the femoral nerve and obturator nerve, this anterior primary lamina of the spinal nerves give rise to ventral division and dorsal division. Now the ventral division of all this, that is L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. The ventral division of all these nerves combine together to form the tibial part of sciatic nerve. So this is the tibial part of sciatic nerve. So the tibial part is formed by the union of ventral divisions of L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3 spinal nerves. Now we know that the sciatic nerve has got a tibial part as well as a common peroneal part. Now how is the common peroneal part then formed? So it is formed by the combination of this, that is the dorsal division of anterior primary lamina of L4, L5, S1 and S2. So here S3 is not included. The dorsal division of anterior primary lamina of L4, L5, S1 and S2. All this combined together to form which part? This is the common peroneal part of sciatic nerve. So common peroneal part is formed by the union of dorsal divisions of anterior primary lamina of L5, S1 and S2. So this is very important. That is the tibial part, the root value is L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. But the common peroneal part has root value L4, L5, S1, S2. S3 is not there. But when you are asked about the root value of sciatic nerve, it is, we know that this is owned by the common peroneal part as well as tibial part, both this combined together to form the sciatic nerve. So the root value of sciatic nerve is L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. This is very important from the exam point of view. So we have discussed so far about the formation, root value of sciatic nerve. Now we are going to discuss about the cause and relations of the sciatic nerve. So first we will discuss the cause. So if this is the sacrum, so we know that the piriformis muscle is emerging from the pelvis side by digitations there, and through the greater sciatic foramen it is entering the gluteal region. Now this is a branch of sacral plexus is emerging in front of the, in the pelvis, it lies in front of the piriformis muscle. So if this is the piriformis muscle and this is the sciatic nerve is lying over the piriformis muscle in the pelvis. So this is the relation in pelvis. So in pelvis, what lies posterior to the sciatic nerve? So posterior relation is formed by piriformis muscle. Now what happens? Now the nerve enters the nerve has to enter the gluteal region. Now we'll draw the diagram again. So this is roughly the diagram of the pelvis. You can see the sacrum here and you can see the pelvis here. This is the ischial tuberosity. This is the greater trochanter of the femur. And you can see the fibula and the tibia here. So we are going to discuss about the quiescent relations of the sciatic nerve here. So the sciatic nerve, it emerges from the pelvis and you can see the piriformis muscle here. The piriformis muscle is a key muscle of the gluteal region, is like this. So this muscle enters the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen. This is the greater sciatic foramen and gets inserted into the apex of the greater trochanter of femur. Now the nerve which emerges from here, it emerges, first of all it is lying anterior to the piriformis muscle in the pelvis. Now the nerve reaches the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen. Now it passes, it enters the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen. It lies inferior to which muscle? It lies inferior to the piriformis muscle. Now it runs downwards and it lies midway between the ischial tuberosity and the greater trochanter femur. Now it is passing over which all muscles? So first of all we know that it is passing under the cover of gluteus maximus muscle. So this is the upper border of gluteus maximus muscle, this is the lower border of gluteus maximus muscle. So in the gluteal region, the gluteus maximus muscle is lying over the sciatic nerve. So in the gluteal region, what is the relation? So the what lies superficially over this nerve? Superficially we can see the gluteus maximus muscle which is lying over this nerve. So the superficial or posterior relation is formed by gluteus maximus muscle. Now the deep relation. What lies deep to the sciatic nerve in the gluteal region? Deep relation or anterior relation is formed by which all muscles? So we know that there is another muscle here, that is obturator internus, which is emerging from the inner aspect of the pelvic aspect of the obturator membrane, and it passes into the gluteal region through the lesser sciatic foramen. Now the tendon of obturator internus is lying deep to the sciatic nerve. Now there is another tendon, that is gamellus superior and gamellus inferior, that is lying behind the sciatic nerve. Now the sciatic nerve passes above these structures, passes over these structures. Now another muscle here is quadratus femoris, that is a quadrilateral muscle. Now there is a transverse part of adductor magnus muscle. So all these muscles are lying deep to the sciatic nerve. The only muscle which is lying over the sciatic nerve or superficial to sciatic nerve is the gluteus maximus. All other muscles which we have discussed now, that is first one, which is this muscle or tendon of obturator internus. Then superior and inferior gamellus superior, gamellus inferior, gamellus inferior. And quadratus femoris. Now obturator externus muscle also. And upper transverse fibers of adductor magnus. Now can you name any other vessel here? So one such vessel which is passing below the piriformis muscle, that is the inferior gluteal vessels, and that is the inferior gluteal vessel. So in the gluteal region, the medial relation is formed by inferior gluteal vessels. Now you can see now after passing through the lower border of the gluteus maximus, it enters the thigh. Now it, on entering the thigh, it passes like this. Now which all muscles lie here? Which all muscles you have here? Having biceps femoris muscle. Now biceps femoris, it is arising from the supromedial aspect of ischial tuberosity, and it gets inserted into the head of fibula. So this is the biceps femoris muscle. Now this muscle is crossing the sciatic nerve in the thigh. So in the thigh, anterior relation or superficial relation or posterior relation is formed by, superficial or posterior relation is formed by, so we are seeing the posterior aspect, so it is the superficial or the posterior relation. It is formed by biceps femoris muscle. And which structure, which muscle is lying deep to the sciatic nerve? We can see the adductor magnus muscle is lying on the deeper aspect. And see, the nerve is lying over the adductor magnus muscle. So this deep or anterior relation is owned by adductor magnus muscle. Now we can see there are two muscles here, that is semitendinosus and semimembranosus muscle. So semitendinosus having a common origin with the biceps humerus muscle, it gets inserted into the upper part of medial surface of tibia. So part of this is tendon. And we have another muscle, that is the semimembranosus, that is arising from the supralateral aspect of ischial tuberosity, that is lying deep to the semitendinosus muscle, and it is getting inserted into the posterior part of the medial condyle of tibia. Now these two muscles, you can see it is lying medial to the sciatic nerve. So medial relation is formed by semitendinosus and semimembranosus. Now we know that the biceps humerus has got a short head. The short head of biceps humerus, it is arising from the lateral lip of the linea aspera. It is lying lateral to the sciatic nerve. Only the long head is crossing the sciatic nerve in the posterior aspect of thigh. So what forms the lateral relation? It is the biceps humerus. So these are the relations of the nerve in the thigh. Now what happens to the nerve in the thigh? It runs vertically downwards up to the superior angle of the popliteal fossa. So if this is the superior angle of the popliteal fossa, it runs up to this part and it divides into tibial and the common peroneal part. At the superior angle of the popliteal fossa, the nerve is dividing into tibial part and common peroneal part. So we have discussed about the course of the nerve. After emerging from the pelvis anterior to the piriformis, it is entering the gluteal region through the greater sciatic foramen inferior to the piriformis muscle. Now it is passing in the gluteal region under the cover of gluteus maximus muscle. So the gluteus maximus is forming the superficial or posterior relation of the nerve in the gluteal region. Now it is in the gluteal region, it is passing over the obturator internus, superior and inferior gemellus muscle and the quadratus femoris and obturator externus and the transverse fibers of adductor magnus. Now it leaves the gluteal region through the lower border of the gluteus maximus muscle, then it enters the thigh. In the thigh, it passes vertically downwards. In the thigh, it is being crossed by the fibers of long head of biceps femoris. Hence, the long head of biceps femoris is forming the posterior or superficial relation of the nerve in the thigh. And semitendinosus and semimembranosus lies medial to the sciatic nerve, and the biceps femoris itself forms a lateral relation. Now, in the gluteal region, the medial relation is formed by the inferior gluteal vessels. Now what happens to the nerve after passing through the thigh? At the junction of upper 2/3 and lower 1/3 of the thigh, at the superior angle of popliteal fossa, it divides into tibial part and common peroneal part. Now which are the branches? Branches are It gives articular branches to the hip joint. Now the muscular branches are so we have learned in the previous video that the tibial part of the nerve is supplying which all muscle? The semitendinosus, semimembranosus, long head of biceps femoris, then ischial part of adductor magnus. Now the only muscle of the posterior compartment of the thigh which is supplied by the common peroneal part. That is the common peroneal part is supplying. Which part? This is supplying short head of biceps femoris. So that's all about the sciatic nerve. We have learned about the cause of formation of sciatic nerve, the cause of sciatic nerve. We have learned about the relations of the sciatic nerve and the branches. Thank you for watching this video. To see more videos from our channel, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.